What is going on, folks? This is one half of Platinum Gaming Elite here.
And the second half of Platinum Gaming Elite here.
And welcome back to the Reading FC podcast. It's been a long time since we've done this, hasn't it, Adam?
Yeah, it's been a long time, but we'll bring it back.
We decided to bring this back because, we just sat down with quite bored and we had nothing else to do. So, we're back with the third episode here of our podcast. And, Adam, are you looking forward to talking about, the week's events, what's gone on with Reading?
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it. And, yeah, just let's straight into it.
So, we're going to review, three games for you guys in this episode. We're going to be reviewing the Bradford game, which was the away game. We're going to be reviewing the Tuesday night game against Brighton, and we'll also be reviewing the game that went on Saturday, which was not a too pleasing result. It happened yesterday, and we ended up picking up a 4-1 defeat, but we're going to go in chronological order, so we're going to go ahead and go with the Bradford game. So, Adam, what did you make of Reading's performance up at Bradford?
Reading's performance against Bradford, it wasn't the best. I think they could have done much better, but there's one man who done a lot of work for the boys, Jay Mackey, but we'll get into him more in this episode. But yeah, so performance was good, but it wasn't too bad. I could have done better. The pitch wasn't the best, though. The pitch was terrible. Obviously, me and you watched on TV because, you know, it's quite a trip up there and it's really in the morning, but we're not really morning people, are we? So we could have asked. But yeah, yeah, it wasn't the best.
What did you think of Alex Pearce and Michael Hector at the back? I thought they played really well.
Yeah, they played really well. It was a shame about Pearce's nose getting broken.
I'm sure he'll be back for Monday's game, which is actually tomorrow. And I was wanted to ask you, what do you think of the centre back pairing? Because I thought Alex Pearce and Michael Hector played really well together.
Yeah,
we've kind of seen them grow over this season. Like, Michael Hector's been the inexperienced player. Alex Pearce is kind of guiding him the way, and I really like the way they two have partnered up since Steve Clark's come in, because he's kind of disciplined them both as well, which I think Nigel Atkins kind of lacked in.
Yeah, I remember when me and you, well, last season we saw Hector always warming up on the bench, didn't we? All the time.
Never got a game, constantly on the bench.
But now he's starting every game. Even in cup games, he's starting. But I just can't. I'm looking forward to tomorrow, well, guys. This is a Sunday, so the Bradford game away is tomorrow. But anyway, what do you think about Reading's performance against Bradford?
Well, I actually thought we'd done quite well. I mean, Pogrebniak was really unlucky not to score. I know. I'm glad he didn't score the handball goal, because it would have been a lot of controversy and all the media would have, just been so aggressive towards Reading. So I'm kind of glad Pogrebniak's goal didn't score that, because, you know, the cup competitions, they're kind of bumming Bradford, we need to support Bradford and everything like that, and they all want the cup fairy tale to be Bradford. I don't know if you know the Copper 90, the YouTube channel?
Yeah.
When the draw was announced, I was on Twitter, and they were like, oh yes, it's Bradford versus Arsenal, and everyone's completely writing off Reading, and I really don't understand this, and it's something that's really annoying me. So I thought our performance up there was actually quite good. I think we were the better team, if I'm honest. We defended and sat back well, and I think we played good football. When the introduction of Gareth McCleary came on, he played really well. Hal Robson Carney didn't have the best of games either. What do you think of Robson?
Well, Carney, in the Bradford game?
Yeah.
Bradford game, he did not do very well at all. He didn't get into the game very well. And again, we weren't there to see it. So, and again, we did watch it on TV, but overall, Robson Carney did not have the best of games, in my opinion. But I've seen him do much better. It's probably one of those games, but hopefully next time, well, tomorrow's game, he'll buck up his ideas and get some goals in for us.
Well, I'd actually like to not see him start. I'd like to see him come off the bench around about the 60-minute mark, because he's one of them players that doesn't have an impact. He's good when he's only played half an hour. First half hour, you see Robson Kanu and you see whoa, this guy's going to have a good game. Then he just turns shocking again, as always. I just don't see the point of having Kanu on the pitch after he's played 30 minutes. So I'd like to see him kind of be introduced around about the 60th minute mark, just in case we do go to
extra time. Yeah, I agree.
Yeah, just in case we do go extra time penalties, because, you know, he is our marquee penalty taker.
I wouldn't like to see it. I wouldn't like to see it go penalties at all.
Oh, no, I would dread it. I would not like to see it go penalties. But, you know, if worst comes to worst and we do go penalties, we have some capable penalty takers in our side. We have Jakubu, who was Blackburn's main penalty taker. We have Nick Blackman, Robson Kanu, Simon Cox can take one. Pogrebniak was our penalty taker last year. So we've got a lot of penalty
but
takers. Can they
take the penalty under pressure? That's the thing, though.
That's what we need to find out. But
let's get on to the Tuesday game. The Tuesday game against Brighton. So what do you feel about the boys' performance?
This was the Jamie Mackie show. In my opinion, this was just 100% Jamie Mackie. He scored two goals. He absolutely ran the show. And as soon as he came off the field, I did not think Reading played too well. Jamie Mackie, he's started putting in the performances now. What's your opinion on Mackie?
Mackie?
Yeah.
I wasn't really too happy with it when he first came. I didn't think he was putting his weight at all. Wasn't really trying,
yeah,
but
how you feel?
To be honest, I think he started, you know, he's been playing very well recently. I think he's just done it a bit too late, really. Because if he'd done this, when
he
first
gets us joined to Wembley,
If he gets us to Wembley, we've got to sign him up,
yeah.
Sure. Well, I think we should sign him up. He's just been fantastic the past couple of games.
But
again, I do wish he would have done it more earlier in the season.
But apparently, he's on high wages up in Forest. He's still got a year left on his contract. And apparently, the Forest players want him back. They're saying that he's one of the players they want to see. So, I don't know if we can expect Jamie Mackie to sign for Reading. But if we do,
and hopefully we'll snag him,
I'll be really happy. Another thing about Mackie, do you want him to start on Monday?
That's a tough question. I've said this millions of times to you. I think he plays better when he comes from the sub. Well, he comes on the pitch later on in the game because he can't last the whole game running around, can he? Do you think? And you agree with that?
Well, I think Jamie.
He can't work hard, 90 minutes.
I think he can.
I don't think he can. I think if they bring him on, I think that'd be better for him. But then again, I know he's going to start.
Well, he's played well when he started, Jamie Mackie. It's when he comes off the bench he doesn't play well.
Really?
Yeah, that's what I think. And I'm happy to see Mackie start, because he's starting up front as well, which makes it even better. So, that's all I've got to say. Mackie's playing really well. But there was one bit of controversy in the game. It was the penalty. Jake Cooper gave it away. Adam, did you think it was a penalty?
I don't know. Do you think it was a penalty, did you?
No, I don't think it was a penalty.
I don't think so.
Nah, Jake Cooper.
Really.
What did you think it was?
I don't know. I wouldn't say it was. I'm not really sure.
Yeah, I don't think it was, because he taps the player and the player's gone down. I don't see the point. What's the point of giving the penalty if he's just only touched him? Anything else to recap from the Brighton game?
The Brighton game.
Oh, I can't think of anything else.
It's just overall a good performance.
It was just a bit uneventful.
Yeah.
It was another poor display from Robson Kanu.
Yeah, you can say that. But let's get on to the game happened yesterday.
I want to touch on Blackman as well.
Oh, okay.
He started up front, didn't he?
Yeah.
That game, and he played really well. He didn't make the biggest impact. He won a lot of aerial battles, but I think we should still stick him out on the wing.
Yeah.
But yeah.
I think he deserves a start tomorrow.
Do you think he should start? Really?
Instead of Robson Kanu.
Yeah, it's the Robson Kanu, yeah.
Right, so...
Do you want to crack into Saturday's game?
Yeah.
Right.
I can see what... this is against Watford. yesterday. We lost 4-1, but then again, we do have a sort of excuse. We did play our youngsters, so...
Yeah, but you got to take a look at the side as well. The side that we put out for that game, we made a lot of changes. Niall Keown came in for his professional debut. We even put Novakovic on the bench, the American striker we signed a couple of years ago, and he apparently was all right. We started with Yakubu and Cox up front. Flipping Ryan Edwards was on the bench. We had a lot of second string players out. Danny Guthrie started. We had a lot of poor players on the pitch. I say poor players, not Reading standards just yet. They're not the best.
So
players.
You're saying Simon Cox is not Reading standards yet?
With the goal rate that he's doing, I don't think. No. He hasn't scored since the 28th of December. You can't be a Reading striker and expect to stay in a squad. Mackie's got 4 in his last 6. That stays in the squad, surely.
Yeah. He's done really well.
But we made 11 changes actually to the side for Watford that played against. Well, we made 11 changes from the side that played against Brighton to the game that played against Watford, if that makes sense. But the team lineup actually was a massive change-up, as you can see. We had Anderson, Keown, Cooper, Zach Knight came in for his debut as well. Yuri Travner played. Jack Stacey also came in for his debut. Taylor, Guthrie, Akpan, Yakubu, Cox, and then listen to the bench. This proves how much he needs to he needs the win on Monday. We got Sean Long, Dan Lincoln. Federici wasn't even in the squad. Dan Lincoln played again, as I said. Novakovic, Aaron Cool came back into the side. Blackman was there. Karajan came back for the first time in around since Huddersfield. Ryan Edwards. So we had a lot of players that were just there, not big players playing on the pitch. So yeah, what did you think of this performance? Well, what did you think?
Yeah, I don't know. I'm not too annoyed. Because I can see Steve Clark's not focused on the league anymore. He's really focused on this, the FA Cup. Don't you think?
Yeah, I can see as well. I mean, we conceded like 30 seconds into the game. Abdi scored before a minute had even passed. Vidra scored as well. Troy Deeney, Foriesti. That just proves the calibre that Watford have. But they haven't got a cup game in 48 hours. So you can see why Steve Clark rested the side. One big positive to come out of Saturday was Cem Karajan. He did score a goal,
yeah.
Didn't he? Yeah, it's a good goal actually. In fact, I watched it on the Football League show. Did you see it?
No, I didn't see it. I forgot to record it.
But yeah, it was a pretty good goal by Karajan, 20-yarder. Kind of replicating his goal at Amadeuski last year against Watford. Would you like to see the introduction of Cem Karajan back in the side again
for Monday's game?
Just in general.
Yeah, I like him
coming back.
He shows himself. He shows belief in himself, still belief in he's going to be the club's. Well, he's the club's captain.
Yeah.
So yeah. So I'm really hoping he does. He's not going to be making too many appearances this season for the end of it, I don't think. But next season, hopefully, he'll be back to his old self.
Well, his contract actually does run out in the summer, and we do have the option of renewing it for an extra season. Would you take the risk and renew it, or would you let him go?
I don't know. I think he's a good player, so I would renew it.
Yeah, same, I'd renew it as well. I love Karajan, I have him on the back of my away shirt, and I think he's a good player. I think he's honestly a good player, and yeah, he's just good, and I don't know, I can't really think of anything to say, because he hasn't played too much football, and if we introduce him back into the side like we have done in the last couple of games, I reckon he'll be back in the starting lineup eventually, because the midfield hasn't really been performing up to scratch. I don't think Chalobah's been what people have expected. Oliver Norwood hasn't been as well since he got the form at the start of the season. He hasn't really done too much since. Danny Williams, yeah, he's the only one I'd say keeps his place. But yeah,
I think Chalobah's done really well. I rate Chalobah really well, do you?
Do you?
Yeah. But yeah, let's get on to tomorrow's game.
You want to change? You don't want to say anything else about a Watford game?
No, let's just forget about that Watford game.
It was basically Reading under 21s versus Watford, I think.
So, yeah. Anyway, big game tomorrow. James, opinions on it?
I am nervous as hell. That's all I've got to say about the game. I think we should pick up the win. We're playing at our ground. They're not going to be used to our pitch. The pitch is going to suit us more.
But then again, Bradford, they beat Chelsea on one of the nicest pitches in the world, you could say. So,
yeah, but Bradford haven't got quality. I think Chelsea just took it as, oh yeah, look, we're playing against a side that we're going to easily take on fresh. So I don't think Chelsea put their strongest, like, performance in the world. So I can still see Reading picking up a win, because Bradford, most of their fans think they're in the semi-finals. Their fans think they're at Wembley already.
Then again, say some Reading fans do as well.
Oh no, judging from Twitter, I don't think anyone thinks Reading's in the final already. in the semis already. But I think Bradford fans, they think they're already in the final. That's going to cost them. Bradford also, they've been a bit cocky going into this. Phil Parkinson saying in the press that we should easily beat Reading. And yeah, he's a club legend and everything, but come on, you shouldn't be saying things like that. You can't say, oh yeah, we're easy going to thrash this team. Because that's not how football works, is it?
But hopefully Reading play well, because it's sold out. It's sold out, isn't it?
Yeah, sold out.
So
around about 23,000, 24,000 fans.
Finally, we're not going to be embarrassed by our attendance.
On a Tuesday or Monday.
Yeah.
Or Wednesday.
To be honest, that would be more attendance than the Burnley against City game yesterday. That would be.
Really?
How much is that? 22,000.
Is that it?
23,000, yeah. But yeah, hopefully, because we're at home, who do you think is going to be starting then?
Well, what
name
I'd
the
go
starting
for,
11.
If I was Steve Clarke, I'd go for Federici, Super Stephen Kelly, I'd go for Pierce, Hector. That is if Pierce can play. If not, I would go for Cooper. Obita, Williams, either Chalobah or... No, I wouldn't put Karajan just yet, because he's still going to be a bit weak, isn't he?
Yeah,
I'll put Karajan... not Karajan, I can't even speak. I would put... There you go, I can speak. I would put Chalobah and Williams in the midfield, and then I would put Hal Robson... No, I wouldn't. I'd put Blackman and McCleary on the wings. Then I'd play Pogrebniak and Mackie up front. What about you?
Yeah, similar, but I'll put Federici in goal. Nah, sorry. Dan Duncan in goal.
You'll have Stuart Moore in goal. Bring back Stuart Taylor, I don't care.
Nah, I think Federici in goal. Ibita, Gunter, Pierce, Hexer.
You play Gunter? I'll play.
Yeah, no. No, this is what I think he's going to play.
Oh. Would you play Kelly, though?
I would play Kelly. I think Kelly's been a great performance, but...
I think Kelly's best player at Reading.
I think Gunner's going to play... I think he might play Norwood.
Norwood,
Chalobah, and Danny Williams.
Oh, you reckon he'll go for the five in midfield again?
Yeah, with... Mackie and Blackman.
So, and then Robson, Carney, or McCleary?
No, and I was going to start with Cox. Cox up front. Pogrebniak.
I was going to say, I reckon he'll start with Big Pog.
But then again, I could say you start with Jamie Mackie instead of Pog.
Well, up front, just as lone striker. I wouldn't put him as a lone striker. I think we need two strikers up front.
Yeah.
Because their defence looked weak when we played them. They did not look good, their defence. It looked pretty weak when we played them in the Cup away. So I think if we can go at them, then I think we could beat them.
Yeah.
Yeah, but that's about it, isn't it?
That's about it, yeah.
So, the other news that really was there that night signed.
Yeah, he's got a free agent, so yeah. So,
yeah, we're bringing in all the old players. That's now Zach Knight and Yakubu. So, yeah, we're also bringing in unknown players. Don't forget, Yuri Travner. But, yeah, that's going to be it.
That's going to be it. But, yeah, that's going to be it for this episode. Yeah, this is hopefully... If we're going to do this weekly now, so... Sorry, this has been, like... Is this our first one this year? This one this year, is it?
Yeah, first one of 2015.
Yeah. So, yeah, hopefully we're going to be... You'll be seeing these more, but anyway,
click the like button if you've enjoyed it.
Yep, subscribe, and then come on Reading for tomorrow.
Come on, you arse.
See you later. Peace.
Peace.